The science community has granted us a wealth of knowledge that can never be overstated. Things that used to mystify our ancestors can now be understood and more appreciated. It's shaped our view of the world, the universe, the animal kingdom, human psychology. Literally everything you know has been helped along by science and the men and women who dedicate their lives to finding out the who's, what's, when's, why's, and how's of stuff. We owe them a tremendous debt of gratitude. But with science having that intrinsic aspect of being ever-evolving, it's never foolproof or absolute. Built right into the scientific method are allowances for screw-ups or just plain not knowing something. And you might be surprised that some very basic parts of life here on our planet, they totally baffle some of our best and brightest minds. In the video today, we're looking at some examples of mysteries that science has yet to crack. Number 10. Why do we sleep? Now here's one you think we'd have nailed down by now. Almost every single person in the world sleeps daily, unless you're a Rolling Stones guitarist, that is. And the answer probably seems obvious to most of us. We sleep to rest our bodies after the day's end. We can hold off on food, water, even sex for days on end, but when it's sleepy time, nature takes over and our bodies just ask for the check. Except it's not as simple as just needing rest. Science has made guesses, which include all sorts of reasons for sleep, like making time for our brains to get things in order after a long day, to reinforce memories, or to replenish fuel lost while awake. But then you throw in examples of plants and other organisms that don't have any brains at all, like we do, and yet they still have sleep patterns that are similar to ours. Further, you can also consider people who have gene mutations, which mean they don't have to sleep very much, and you can see that we don't really understand sleep very much at all. Number 9. How does gravity work? Gravity, as we learn in school, is very simple, right? There are forces within our planet, things that pull toward the center. So if you throw something in the air, it comes back down. Gravity keeps you on the ground. It's also what keeps the planets orbiting around the sun. This is all very simple, and we've known it since we were able to learn new information. So why does science have so much difficulty explaining it? Basically, gravity is one of the four forces in our universe, which also include electromagnetism, strong nuclear, and weak nuclear. Gravity is the weakest of the four, and while we seem to grasp the concept of gravity with earthly examples, when things get too small or too big, like black holes and atoms, that's when science and Newton's principles don't really make sense. And a simple science experiment you've seen before, where a balloon rubbed on your shirt creates enough electromagnetism to negate gravity and lift your hair or a piece of paper, shows just how easily gravity can sometimes simply disappear. Number 8. Why are most people right-handed? People seem to take notice when someone uses their left hand for something, as if it's some kind of freak mutation that's just manifested itself. And while it's rare for someone to be a natural southpaw, about 10% of the world's population, it's not quite the same thing as running across someone who has, for example, horns growing out of their head. So why do people deviate from the norm in terms of handedness? Is it a genetic mutation? Is it the environment they're brought up in? Is it hereditary? Well, science doesn't really know, and it doesn't really have an empirically established way to measure handedness. Science does lean toward genetics, but there are even problems with that, as some teachers in school force children to become right-handed when learning to write, and there is some data as to cultural and societal factors influencing which hand becomes dominant. Weirdly enough, we've learned why people become right-handed, but not why right is the right way, if that makes sense. Number 7. Why does anesthesia work? It's the divine gas that makes people not have to be acutely aware of their leg being amputated, among other things. The introduction of anesthesia granted patients the ability to snooze through all sorts of medical procedures, and it's been a godsend since the mid-1800s. Not only for patients, but also for doctors who had to deal with patients moving about while they were undergoing major surgery because, you know, they could feel everything. What started as an inhaled ether on its inception has become a more refined chemical blend that renders the recipient unconscious. But we really don't know how it does that. Think about it. When you're asleep, you're unconscious, right? But you sure as hell would feel a scalpel opening you up. So why is the anesthesia unconsciousness different? Further, what's a mystery is how the gases and the chemicals work together to take you to such an incredibly deep level of unconsciousness. Indeed, it seems that under anesthesia, different parts of the brain are affected much like a coma patient's would be. All in all, it's a wonderful tool in medicine, and we really don't know why. Number 6. Why do cats purr? You might be thinking right now, well, that's because my cat loves me. But you're ignoring the fact that if your cat was a little bigger, it would absolutely tear your face off. Science as a whole has basically shrugged at this problem and kind of said, I don't know. See, cats also have a tendency to purr when they're scared or hungry. Purring probably isn't a form of communication, as it's too low and local to be really effective. Also, in the realm of just pure weirdness, science has discovered that purring has been linked to bone regeneration. So there are many theories we have for why kittens just sit there and gently hum their bodies, but most likely it's just a way for them to soothe themselves. Kind of like how we laugh for several different reasons. Number 5. Why was there a mysterious hum in New Mexico? New Mexico has a weird history of everything from nuclear bomb testing to Walter White standing on a dirt road in his tighty whities. But the residents of the northern town of Taos have their own strange tale to tell, and it's in reference to a local phenomenon called the Taos hum. Since the early 90s, people in the town have described some kind of tangible audio event. Some call it a whirring kind of noise, or a buzz, or a humming in the air around the town. A professor of engineering at the University of New Mexico studied the sounds around Taos and noticed that around 2% of the population was susceptible to the strange hum. That doesn't mean that they picked up any unusual sounds while conducting their research. Quite the opposite, in fact. Their very sensitive audio recording equipment and vibration sensors picked up nothing out of the ordinary. The fact that the townsfolk heard differing kinds of sounds is also of less scientific value than if they had all heard the same one low persistent hum. And that's why science is more keen to dismiss the Taos hum as being part of the onslaught of background noise humans live with these days, mixed with subjective hearing experiences from the people themselves. The residents of Taos, however, stand firm in their belief of a weirder explanation because, well, it's New Mexico after all. Number 4. The ancient Baghdad batteries. Now hear us out here. What if we told you that researchers working in Iraq in the 1930s found what totally appeared to be some kind of crude battery that may have been used to produce electrical charges, and that it likely dated from around 200 BC? Of course, this would predate that kind of technology by, well, a couple of thousand years. What archaeologists originally thought were some kind of clay storage pots turned out, upon closer inspection, to contain copper rods within them. This led scientists to strongly believe that the pots would have held some kind of substance that would react to the copper rods and produce electricity. But why? Theories range from using the charge to shock people as punishment — those were strict days, after all — to using that electricity to electroplate things with gold. Another school of thought is that they found a way to make electricity long before knowing what the heck it was good for, kind of like the Chinese with gunpowder. Number 3. Why does the placebo effect work? You've all heard the basics of the placebo effect. It's a treatment that isn't real, but the very act of a patient believing in its effectiveness creates its own beneficial properties. If you expect a pill or drug to do something, it's likely to work in some way. It might seem mean, but science does need to use placebos when testing new medications. Rather maddeningly, this data is often skewed because, well, sometimes the placebos work. But why? Well, we don't really know. The point of a placebo is that you don't know you're taking it. But that opens up a whole host of problems, because placebos can often work even when you know that you're taking one. That clearly goes against its entire purpose. In 2009, researchers testing treatments for irritable bowel syndrome found many subjects who knowingly took placebos got better at higher rates than those who received no treatment at all. That's pretty insane, and it seems that a person's personality is tied to whether the placebo effect will work or not. But it's really just guesswork so far. But if that's not enough stuff that science doesn't get, there's also potentially an inverse nocebo effect, where if you don't believe a treatment will work, your symptoms will get worse. And really, the only explanation is that our brains are totally weird. Number 2. Why are we getting repeating radio bursts from space? No, don't worry, we're not going all History Channel. Let's lay out the basics first. A fast-repeating signal burst from space, called FRB-121102, was first discovered in 2012. While we've come across some of these before, this one has repeated itself, though sporadically. The bursts usually last about a millisecond, and we don't yet know where they originate from. We know it's from a galaxy about 3 billion light-years away that was recently discovered, but that's about all. The radio bursts, though short, are massive, containing as much energy as the Sun produces in a day. The fact that it's persistent and repeating makes scientists think the location could be near a black hole or a nebula. Science's best guess is that the source itself is a pulsar or a neutron star. But that doesn't mean that the scientists are ruling out extraterrestrial origins, mostly because, well, that would probably spoil all the fun. Number 1. How bicycles really work. Really? If science can't work out how bicycles work, are we really supposed to trust them at all? Well, yes you are, but it's still an interesting mystery. Much of the mystery concerns the bicycle without a rider perched on it. If the bike is going fast enough, it's going to want to balance itself so it doesn't fall over. It even does when someone is riding on it to a degree. That self-stability, and why it occurs, has eluded scientists since the 19th century. The commonly held idea is that the gyroscopic effect of the rotating front wheel keeps the bike stable, but that's fallen apart under recent analysis. An alternate theory likens the wheel on a bicycle to the wheels on a shopping cart in that they align themselves automatically in the direction of travel. This theory has also recently fallen apart, and it seems that science does truly have a point where they just decide to go and have lunch. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below. Don't forget to subscribe. We got brand new videos just like this every day of the week. While you're subscribing, hit that notification bell so you actually find out when we put out new videos. That would be awesome. And I'll see you next time.